Guy performs all over the Bay Area, hilarious. Ladies and gentlemen, you know him. Danny, how are you, everybody? Guys, don't pause. I'm not going to rap. I wish I could rap. Be fun. Closest I can come to a melody is just going like, USA! USA, USA, USA! You guys been watching the Olympics at least though? Yeah. Guys, you're so fucking good at sports. It's so great. I think that's probably why everybody in the world hates us. Probably the only reason.
Bastard Americans winning all the gold medals! Death to all Americans! Like, shit, that's how world wars start, guys. That's how it goes.
I think it's wonderfully ironic that the first Olympic medal that was won by an American teenage shooter. Let that sink in for a second. Wow. That is some awful stuff right there. It's pretty funny. She strikes me as the type to thank God, probably, you know? But not like in a cool black guy kind of way, but probably in like a, I think it's cool to kiss my cousin, vote Trump kind of way. You know? You can't get first place without the Second Amendment. That's right. Yeah. I mean, it is technically true. He's probably practiced a number of times, but yeah, I'm loving it, guys. I think it's super fun. I'm just glued to my phone, like checking Twitter and like following the medals. Like Pokemon Go needs any fucking competition for my attention on my phone. I see Arpan was playing Pokemon Go. Anybody else play Pokemon Go? Yeah. Guys, yeah, don't be shy, guys. I obviously play Pokemon Go. Guys, let's go. Thank you, Chad. His wife hates him right now. That's a true story. Anyway, love you, buddy. He's with me. So for those of you guys that don't know, or I guess for those of you that play, what the fuck is up with the professor? Is he a pedophile? Right? So those of you guys that don't know, one of the main, like, core mechanics of this game is to just catch a bunch of Pokemon that you don't need, and then transfer them to the professor to give you candy. And this professor apparently just has a shit ton of candy lying around, and it makes me think, like, who is this guy that just sits in his little office, he's got an endless supply of candy, he wants kids to come in and give him their Jigglypuffs? Like, yeah, I don't like this guy. And he's sitting there, he's like, so I like Pokemon? So I got a bunch of squirrel candy down the cellar.
That's a little crazy.
Anyways, I digress. So being hooked to technology is what we were talking about.
Alright.
I love Pokemon Go. So being hooked on technology, I think my generation is really, really like prone to get hooked on technology. Because if you remember what it was like before like all this cool shit was out, like before everybody had an iPhone in their pocket and all that stuff. You know, like back when like online men like you know, and you had to sit there and wait for it. And like the only thing that you can show off on your phone was like your high score in Snake and like what, like what's that, right? Like your and what, like the tribal image that was on your detachable faceplate on your Nokia, right? Some people know what I'm talking about. I think hopefully the next generation won't be as addicted. And it's kind of like a reverse psychology thing, right? Because they're basically born with iPads in their faces, right? So maybe like after a while, you know, in between turning themselves into a puppy on Snapchat, they might be able to kind of look and say, you know, maybe I'm cool to take a break off of this for a minute. Like, I don't know. It's kind of like my hope for the future generation. Who am I kidding? We're fucked. I am scared as hell to have a kid with like all this technology. Like, how do you raise a kid with all of this that's like going on today, right? Like, I'm probably going to be one of those parents that sticks an iPad in my baby's face. Well, I hope Siri takes care of it. You know, whatever else going on. Right? Like, is that a thing? Like, can Siri raise my kid? Like, let me ask Siri a question. You know. My phone is being non-responsive because, true story, I dropped it in the toilet about an hour ago. It's okay. No, it works. It works. Although it says that a cable does not work, so it's broken. Did I ask Siri if she was alive? Does she have a funny response today?
Yep.
She probably is. I'm going to have to try it later. I'm nervous about if it will actually work, but let me see. So first off, I want to see, let's see if I can have it tell me about the birds and the bees. Right, Siri, can you tell my kid about the birds and the bees?
Don't be a lazy asshole. Go back out.
Nice.
What the hell, Siri? I think her and I are going to have to be in a fight. All these smart-ass questions that I'm going to be answering her, I mean...
You heard me, and if I have to say it again, I'm going to make sure that you ruin your mind. I'm
really
going to do it. I
commend
you if I wanted to. Raise your kid
right. Holy shit, Siri. Tough fucking luck right there. I would be in luck if there was a Siri app for parenting. I actually had the next best thing. I had an overbearing Middle Eastern mother. It's always on, it's always available, it connects everything that you need. My mom is fantastic. She's one of these tiny little Middle Eastern people with like a funny accent, but that maintains.
No, I don't have an accent.
Kind of do, Mom. You kind of do. But, yeah, I mean, like, if my mom were an operating system, I think she'd be in heaven. Like, I would have to be like, hey, phone, text this girl that I like.
Well, no, I don't like her.
Mom, like, let me talk to this person. I think if my mom would be an operating system, she would, like, you know, make sure it's, like, in my car, in the home, on my phone. It would be, like, the motherly, overreaching module, the MOM, right? And then it'd be like, hey, MOM, call my fiance.
Well, no, Danny. 2 hours since you called me, so call me Mom.
Mom, it's ruining my life. Smart car, my ass, be driving down the freeway as soon as I hit the speed limit.
Daddy, please, slow down!
Car? Like, what? I'm like, no, MOM, I'm going to speed limit.
Well, it's a little too fast for me. Slowing down the car, applying brakes, I can see belt.
Shit. Really shitty. Mom? MOM module? Check me in on Facebook. It's one of these voting booths.
Okay, but only if you're voting for Obama.
Okay, Mom, you can't vote for Obama anymore, so please don't waste my vote.
Casting vote for Obama.
My mom fucking loves Obama. I mean, I would say who doesn't, but a lot of people don't. But I think he's a really great president. I mean, it's true, a lot of people don't. But I mean, you look at what it's compared to today, like, I don't get, like, too wrapped up into politics. Like, I wish I could break out the song and rap about it. But that was kind of cool, though, right? But no, I don't get, like, too wrapped up. I just think it's kind of funny, like, how politics is just an absolute shit show. Like, it was fun when Bernie Sanders was in it for a while. Because he was, I don't know, like, he just grabbed people. You know what I mean? And what was really funny about him in his big, ill-fitting suit, right, is that, you know, he represented, like, breaking out of the system, and the poor guy looked like a puppet while he said that, which is, like, the very metaphor of the thing that he's trying to go against. You know, like, he sits there and he's like, you need to break out of the system. Don't let anybody tell you what to do. You are your own person. Forget that I look like a fucking marionette. You know, it's kind of funny. I'm throwing my lot in with Hillary. You know, say what you will about politics. I just think it would be hilarious to have sexy fax man Bill Clinton be the first man, right? Whatever that is. You know, like he would kind of pop out in the press conferences and be like, you see that lady over there? The first female president? I totally had sexual relations with that woman. Is this that? Quote? Jesus Christ. Yeah, it's scary though, guys, because you may have heard, right, from here, from social media, from the news, that there's this guy, McDonald, and he's also running, and it is fucked up. I wrote a joke. It immediately became old news, though, because the guy is such a walking shit show that whatever I say is like, well, yeah, obviously, we already know about that. He's already done 10 more things that are fucking crazy, and it's horrible, right? I feel like Donald Trump is like a comic's dream and worst nightmare. Because on one hand, there's a shit ton of material, but on the other hand, it's all completely irrelevant. Kind of like his campaign. I don't know. But, yeah, I don't know. I mean, you can pick any thing that Donald Trump has done or said that's stupid, and it'll probably start to go down the same route anyways. You know, like, pick anyone you want. Like, did you see those pictures of my wife? They were fabulous. They were some of the best. She looked fabulous. Ask anybody. The rest of the three kids.
I told the Russians to leave them. They were part of the deal. One of the best deals. No, I think the winning deal is the best. It's fabulous. By the way, have you seen the size of my hands? They're huge. Imagine if that says about my man. Then ask anybody. Ask my wife. Ask my daughter. It's huge. It's fresh. Donald Trump and his fucking deals that make sense. Whenever Donald talks about making a deal, I imagine him sitting across a little kid playing Monopoly or something. The little kid is in a tie, he's just staring at him.
If you let me be the top hat, I promise I won't quit any of my shitty hotels or any of the property that I land on.
The little kid agrees to it, you know, and I wish that was a deal that he would actually make in real life. So stop putting shitty hotels everywhere, right? You get a little top hat to cover up the bird's nest. Win-win. It'd be pretty good stuff. I think Donald should just embrace the villain role. Like, wear a top hat, man. I think it'd be funny. Like, just strut around wherever you go, and like, you can wear like a funny little like monocle. You know what I mean? And you can like wear a funny little like armband with like a swastika on it, you know? Like, I think it'd be pretty funny. Embrace it, Donald. You do you, man. I went to Vegas not too long ago, and I'll leave you guys with this, because I saw the big Trump Tower, and I was, you know, kind of like, oh, look at that. But I was so tempted to go in just to see like what the clientele would be like. Like, who's staying at the Trump Hotel nowadays? And I thought about it, I was like, there probably are a lot of people, actually. I imagine a person at the counter was like, excuse me, do you have a discount for straight shooters? That tell it like it is, because that's me, I'll tell you what. He's like, no, there are people like that, guys, because people get all dressed up for Vegas, but you have to remember, that's still fucking Nevada, right? There are still people out there, you know, they may develop capabilities to win gold medals in the future, but it's probably only going to be for shooting things real good. Thanks all for coming out, guys. That's my time. Okay.
Danny Howell-Wing, everybody. Danny Howell-Wing. Right on.